So our definition of a plane wave constrains the relative orientations of the electric and magnetic fields with respect to the direction of propagation. The next question we want to ask is, can we also find a relationship between the magnitudes of the E and H fields? To answer this question, let's look back at the source-free wave equations for electric and magnetic fields. These differential equations have solutions of this form, where we know that the electric field, the magnetic field, and the K vector form a right-handed triad. So for a plane wave traveling along the z-axis, we have this general solution with both forward propagating components and backward propagating components. If we apply Faraday's law to the electric field equation, we can obtain a second expression for the magnetic field in terms of the electric field. We can then equate the forward propagating terms in the first expression for H to the forward propagating terms in the second expression for H to obtain this relationship between forward propagating magnitude of y-directed magnetic field, represented by hy plus, and the forward propagating magnitude of the x-directed electric field, represented by ex plus. We can also equate the backward propagating terms from both expressions to obtain this relationship between the backward propagating electric and magnetic field magnitudes. We will define this coefficient, omega mu over k, as the intrinsic impedance of the wave. Think of this as being analogous to the characteristic impedance on a transmission line. In the same way that characteristic impedance gives the ratio of forward voltage to forward current, intrinsic wave impedance gives the ratio of forward electric field magnitude to forward magnetic field magnitude. And just as characteristic impedance gives the negative ratio of backward voltage to backward current, intrinsic impedance gives the negative ratio of backward electric field magnitude to backward magnetic field magnitude. If you think about this, the sign flip here is actually pretty easy to intuitively understand. Recall, E cross H points in the direction of propagation. The direction of propagation is opposite for the backward wave, so the direction of one of the fields had to flip. That 180-degree turn is where the negative sign comes from. Let's take a moment to think about what we've just done. We said that for a plane wave, if you know the equation for the electric field, you can find the direction of the magnetic field. Now, using the intrinsic impedance, we can find the magnitude of the magnetic field from the magnitude of the electric field. Of course, whenever you know the electric field in a source-free region, you can use Faraday's law to find the magnetic field. But now, if we know that the electric field corresponds to a plane wave, we can also directly write the magnetic field by scaling the magnitude and reorienting the field. For example, if we have an electric field pointing in positive x and positive y, given by this equation, we can see that propagation is in plus z, so the x component of the electric field will contribute a scaled y component to the magnetic field, and the y component of the electric field will contribute a scaled negative x component to the magnetic field. The magnitude scales, and the new directions are simply found using the right-hand rule.